Well, we've just announced our three nominees for the Youth Citizen of the Year Award. There were Zoe Clarke, Abby Jarrett, and Austin Cardinell, and we highlighted their involvement in our community. It's been a wonderful sort of half an hour. We had the parents here and the students from their classes to support them, so just a nice opportunity to celebrate Central Wellington students' involvement in the community.
So the first person who I'd like to come and stand up with me is Abby Jarrett. Where's Abby? So we gathered information from Abby's coaches and Abby's teachers, and here's what they said about Abby. She stands out from her peers. She's upfront with her teachers, and she shows remarkable kindness, bringing Christmas gifts for her guidance counselor, maybe Miss Sadler, and flowers for a teacher who had recently lost a family member. Just a few of Abby's examples of leadership include lifeguard and supervisor at Central Wellington Community Sportsplex, youth member and leader for a Lower Road Christian Fellowship Amplified Youth Group, link leader at CW, volunteer leader for a Lower Road Christian School track and field cross country events, volunteer for CW's 2015 prom committee, supervising timekeeper for CW wrestling tournaments, defenseman for the Grand River Mustangs midget rep BB team, plays flank position for Sunday Wellington District High School rugby team, and she's highly involved in her community, including the Fergus Fall Fair, local dog shows, the food bank, charity events, and missions trip fundraisers. That's why Abby was a great nominee. So congratulations on your nomination. The other nominee that I will speak to is Zoe. Zoe, do you want to come up? Teachers and coaches said about Zoe. Zoe has a love of learning and is a dedicated scholar. She engages in animated discussions with all of her teachers and has a smile and an openness that draws people in. Some of her accomplishments include writing, directing, and acting in the Centre Wellington Theatre Sears Drama Festival, volunteering in the Centre Wellington's Math Help Centre, tuba player for the Centre Wellington Concert Band, performing three plays with the Guelph Youth Theatre and two plays with the Allura Community Theatre. She has written 13 University of Waterloo mathematics contests. She's currently preparing for the Brain Bee, which is a neuroscience competition. She's competed in the Kiwanis Music Festival for concert band, solo voice, and solo tuba. She has excelled in the Royal Conservatory of Music exams, guitar and theory. She's received the Excellence in Community Theatre Award for Best Actress in a Supporting Role. And she volunteers at Wellington Terrace and the Centre Wellington Food Bank, completing over 300 volunteer hours.
I think so.
Yes,
very good. Congratulations on your nomination, Zoe.
So I'm going to speak to our third nominee, and that is Austin, who thinks he's here to record via the grad
event. Really not,
but you're really
I don't
not Austin.
Recorded.
So I think all of you know Austin. Austin's been really involved in our school community for the past 5 years, really, because he did walk across the stage last year, but he came back for a victory lap. He's also a very active member of his church, and for the past 4 years, many of you probably don't know this, but he basically participated in a seminary program where he was at church an hour before school every day.
6 a.m.
6 a.m. So prior to you all probably waking up and getting your butts out of bed in the morning, he was doing this program, which is very, very honorable of him. He also hopes potentially to pursue some missionary work when he leaves Centre Wellington, which is an interesting fact that many of you probably didn't know as well. He is the voice on 92.9 The Grand. Mark Payne even commented recently that he has a better, Austin has a better radio voice than Mark, who gets paid for the gigs, so I thought that was really impressive. He's filmed events for TV Kojiko. This involves attending things like the Scottish Festival, hockey games, various community events. You've probably seen Austin there working in a volunteer capacity and also as a co-op student for a couple of years. He's been involved in our tech crew since the get-go. He's a master light operator, and in the past year he's been our tech head here at school. You all know how many events we have at Centre Wellington, and they're huge to organize. Austin's been a major part of that, including every major theatrical production we've done as well. He's responsible for starting Falcons on the Air on Friday nights, which is our school's radio show, and also for Falcons Media, which is our TV show on TV Kojiko. He has basically ensured that our community knows everything about what's going on here at Centre Wellington High School, and that's to show all of the positive things that we do, which is fantastic. He's also been a peer helper in a variety of classrooms, and in his most recent position, Austin even found himself being a model for theatrical makeup designs on a number of occasions. What a great team player and helping out his peers to be successful. So that says a lot about the kind heart that he has. He's a kind and caring person, and I'm confident that he'll go far, and that's why he was nominated for this award. So congratulations.
Thank you.
And then our mayor, Mayor Linton, announced our winner.
So good work to all the candidates here. Again, just like we said, there's only one winner, and I'd like to announce the Youth Citizen of the Year Award goes to Zoe Clarke.
Zoe's amazing. There's so many I can hardly say. Done more than 300 hours of volunteer work while being very involved in theater, both in the school and in the community, and also a very strong academic student. I think I read she'd written 13 math contests so far in her high school career and done very well. It's just wonderful that the community supports us this way. We really like to reach out to them, and it's nice to have them reach out to us too. Okay.